Okay, so today I am going to present the ab initio result for this collectivity in the ST cell nuclei. So here we will see how this B2 quadrupole moment and magnetic moment works if you use the ab initio interaction. So these are the outlines for this talk. So mainly we will focus on this ab initio interaction, that is a coupled cluster, and then in medium SRG, and then I will show you about how we get a different result for this B2 quadrupole moment and also the magnetic moment. So these interactions are coming from this ab initio approach. So we have a Hamiltonian, we have this two body part, and also we have this three body part. So this three body part is induced power for NTLO, and then this two body part is the basically the N3LO interactions. And we have now core, and then one valence, one body orbit, that is single particle energy, and then we have a two body terms here. And once you break Hamiltonian, so what we will get, there is a problem in interaction, so we need to renormalize that. And in the case of in medium SRG, so strategy is here. So we are going to split our Hamiltonian in two parts, that will be the diagonal and off diagonal terms, and our aim is to just put 0 here, the off diagonal matrix element. Now we use first for this electromagnetic properties for the ST cell nuclei. So we cover here whole the ST cell, so I will show you some result. And also for 13 set of nuclei, we discuss about this Gamow-Taylor strength, how it is working, how to get log FT value and other things. So if we look all these results, so we can also do some things like how this log FT value and then BGT value we are getting if you use this ab initio interaction in the case of SD cell nuclei. So we are going one by one. First we discuss about the electromagnetic, then BGT. Now we are going to discuss about this log FT value in this case. So if you discuss about the island of inversion candidate, so here normal filling of cell model is not obvious. So it is expected we should include in our model space the PF cell nuclei. So in that case, if you include the PF orbital, so in some cases we are getting very good result. So for example, even if you take this SD cells, so CCI results are enough. So these are this, if you take this normal SD cell, and it is possible for some cases once you go n equal to 20 region, the inclusion of PF orbitals are obvious. So here BE2 value, so we need to initial wave function and then final, so it is possible to calculate BE2, and we need this effective charge for this. So after this, we have also calculated what is the quadrupole moment we are getting using this wave function, which are originally from ab initio interactions. So you can see here this spectra, rotational spectra of how these interactions are able to predict. So ab initio interaction also captures about this rotational spectra in the case of energy, if you look about. So we don't need, because we are reaching towards the mid cell, so it means even the cell model is able to explain the collectivity in the case of ST cell nuclei. But problem is here in the silicon. So it might be because we are very far from this SD cell, so might be the interaction is not properly working. So we need some different targeting point for these type of nuclei. So if you look about, if you include this, so how this 2 plus and B2 are working here, so you can see how the ab initio interaction are giving very good result. But once you go n equal to 20 region, so our result is slightly far from that. So later I will show you about if you include the SDPF cell, how it is going to work. So then we have this magnesium isotopes, which is more important here. So you can see here we have the, again there is a problem in n equal to 20 region, but for lower neutron number there is no problem. Even SD cell works very good. So here you can see if we include this PF cell, how the results are giving. And similarly, in the case of silicon, we can see about, again, we have the at n equal to 20, we have a problem here. But important point is collectivity is not so observed in the silicon, even SD cell are enough in this case. So again, we have a, we can also see about how this occupancy is going to, how the occupancy we have for different orbitals. So you can see here, once we have n equal to, a equal to 30, so these orbitals are, PF orbital are very crucial to decide the structure of these nuclei. It means it is very obvious to include the PF cell. Once you go for heavier mass region, maybe around n equal to 20 region in the case of magnesium isotopes. So if you look about next, we have included here 2 particle 2 hole and 4 particle 4 hole calculation. It means we have allowing 4 neutron from HD2PF cell. In the case of silicon isotopes, so you can see here our result is slightly far here. So it might be possible that inclusion of P cell is also crucial in the lower cell. And once you go heavier ones, so we have again the occupancy is going on increasing. But here you can see that SD cell are enough. So we also did survey of all this electromagnetic property for in the case of SD cell nuclei. Here I have given some snapshot of few results. So you can see how this experimental value and these ab initio interactions are working. So important things are these interaction is not so fitted. So it is might be possible that without doing fitting, so we can predict result which might be close to experimental data. So these are the few important points here in this conclusion that PF cell is very, very crucial once you go n equal to 20 region. Here ab initio interactions which are adopted for no core cell model with core is still not working here. So these are the other conclusion that we can say that in medium SRGs are very well working for this lighter nuclei, but not for a heavier one. And the 4 particle 4 hole excitation is very crucial once you go for heavier HD cell nuclei. So these are the major conclusions. Thank you.